Our work involves development of small molecules and nanomaterials that can regulate the biological processes, some of the biological processes. So we consider the cell signaling, how these molecules actually regulate the cell signaling. And we also try to understand the complex chemical pathways of thyroid hormone metabolisms and thyroid hormone diseases at molecular level. So we start with chemical synthesis, and this is done in a chemistry lab. So we design molecules on a paper, and we draw structures of the molecules that we want to make. We optimize several parameters in the lab to get reproducible results and also the purity of compounds. And then the next level of our studies involve testing these compounds in cells. So we use human cells to study this, to understand whether these compounds have any toxicity and how these compounds are taken up by the cells, and also whether these compounds can mediate the desired chemical transformation inside the cells. A major challenge in drug discovery process is that many of the synthetic molecules and proteins, they don't get into the cells on their own, because the cellular membranes do not allow them to enter. And what I found in our laboratory is that introducing a halogen atom to small molecules or proteins, we can transport them inside the cells very efficiently. And the presence of halogen atoms in these molecules actually interact with the cell surface, a specific receptor on the plasma membrane, and which allows these compounds to be transported into specific sites inside the cells. I have been working on reactive oxygen species, and these reactive oxygen species contribute to oxidative stress in the cells. So what they do, these oxidative stress leads to damage to biomolecules like DNA, proteins, and lipids. In long term, these damages lead to diseases like neurodegeneration, cardiovascular diseases, cancer, and aging. So I am interested in developing small molecules and nanomaterials that can control the oxidative stress. And these compounds could be therapeutic candidates for the treatment of diseases like Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, which are associated with oxidative stress. Very recently, it started developing into this area. What happens when we design compounds with desired biological activities? So we want to look into the biological properties of these compounds. And the activities at the interface, working at the molecular level, is actually increasing. But I would like to say that more collaboration and defined collaboration with people coming from different expertise is important to actually get into something more challenging. Aha moment was when we discovered that a simple substitution of a hydrogen atom in a protein by iodine atom facilitates the transport of protein inside the cells. Otherwise, proteins generally don't enter the cells. And what I believe is this could be an interesting strategy to transport protein inside the cells by simple substitution. Started doing some biological activities several years ago in a chemistry lab. Then soon I realized that it's important to establish the facilities and get more funding to do biological research. And I found that it's important to work at the interface of chemistry and biology, bringing people with different expertise, and to address problems that transcends the traditional boundaries of chemistry and biology. And that has been quite successful, and we are able to now establish a fully functional chemistry as well as the biology labs. We would be focusing more on biomedical research, and we would like to develop a conceptually new drug for treating cardiovascular diseases and neurodegeneration. In my opinion, it will be a great achievement if we can take one compound developed in our laboratory to the clinical trial. I was, of course, delighted to hear that, and I was very happy to hear this, that Infosys Science Foundation decided to give this award for the interdisciplinary research that we do. And this is a great motivation. So it is for a country like India, where interdisciplinary research has long been ignored. And this is a great initiative by the Infosys Science Foundation to recognize this particular area. My message would be, please look at the bigger picture. And do not hesitate to break the boundaries of disciplines, entering into multidisciplinary areas, bring people who have multidisciplinary expertise, and try to address a problem that has social relevance.